See, it's nice, isn't it? I can do fucking professional intros, I have you know. I'm very offended by the implication that I can't. Here I am. Hello, how are you? You know, I like to think I can sing like Eric Clapton, actually. Right, he's probably the, like, he's my kind of the voice I can do. Like, singing-wise, I don't think I'm a terrible singer. I'm not a good singer either, but I think that the best sort of kind of style of singing I can do is Eric Clapton. Nobody knows you when you're down and out. He's sort of like this mid-range. In your pocket, not one penny. And as a friend's well, you ain't got any. Because nobody knows you when you're down and out. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Bell-bottom blues, you make me cry. Would you know my name when I saw you in heaven? If you saw me in heaven, would you help me say? If I saw you in heaven, ooh, I'd find my way through night and day. Cause I know it won't be long here in heaven. See? It's not terrible. I'm not bad at singing Eric Clapton. I'm bad at singing some other things like Queen and stuff like that, but Eric Clapton's sort of my kind of voice. I don't think I'm good at singing him either, but you know. Hey, I can't do Layla. He has the gravelly Layla. I got you on my knees, Layla. I can't. It's softer ones, you know. I got the key to the highway where I'm out to go. I'm gonna leave this high. I can't remember the words. That was that song, by the way. That was off Eric Clapton's new album. I'm pretty sure that's an old song. I think that's definitely an old song. But that's his new album. His new album's fucking great, by the way. It's called I Still Do, which I think it means I think that just means he's still, you know, a thing. Yeah, I very much enjoy Eric Clapton. He's one of my favorite artists, sort of next to Mark Knopfler. I think they're sort of up there with my favourite sort of musicians. I mean, I love Brian May, you see. I really, really love Brian May, but I think Brian May's probably my favourite like musician, but I think Eric Clapton and Mark Knopfler are kind of better songwriters as well as musicians. They're a bit softer. I don't sing in the showers, no. I don't. I just shower and I leave. Oh, Mark Knopfler's great. Fucking, I saw Mark Knopfler in the Echo Arena a couple of years back, well, last year. And it's interesting to me because I went to see Emma Blackery perform today. It was a Busted concert. I didn't stay for Busted. I just went for Emma and left after about 20 minutes, which, she thought I should have given the other ones a chance, but it's not my kind of music. It's like, I'm not into pop punk at all. It's not something I enjoy. I'm sure if you watch enough of these streams, you know the kind of music I like. I like my blues, I like my jazz, I like my sort of softer stuff, and I do occasionally like my harder rock, but pop punk is I just don't enjoy it. It's just not my thing. And I actually I've listened to Emma's songs, and I they're not songs I particularly enjoyed. They're good songs. It's not my kind of music. But when I listened to Emma live, I actually enjoyed her immensely more live. I liked it a lot live. I'm not sure why. I'm not sure if I think they were sang a little differently. They're a bit less punk and a bit more kind of rocky. I don't know. It was a bit interesting. Whatever. I have heard Thunderbirds Ago. That's the only Busted song I've ever heard. My voice is still a bit fucked. I can't do that. When the Thunderbirds are go, do 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 do. Do I like you? I don't know what Eurobeat is. I do like kind of older music. I mean, my music tastes are pretty. I mean, my iTunes library currently is Billie Holiday. Lewis Primer. Up a lazy river where the old mill ran. Ella Fitzgerald and Louis Armstrong.
The way you wear your hat, sip your tea. The memory of all
that. Which is weird, because I think sort of I got into a lot of, you know, Eric Clapton. Like, I got into that from my father, because he's a guitarist, and he plays, like, Eric Clapton. He plays this classic blues, and I got into classic blues through him. But he never listened to jazz. I really like jazz, which is weird. What was Emma's gift? Oh, I'm not saying it's secret until I give it to her, and I'm only gonna give it to her in person because I just want to see the look on her fucking face. Power metal. Yeah, a lot of people like power metal. They sleep. They are nice songs. They're relaxing songs. And I'm generally a person who can't relax. I'm generally relaxed, but like I'm always a little on edge. But like I would like Cheap Trick as well. Like. I don't know the words, but like this is the kind of music I like. I don't know. I like this sort of classic-y rock style. I like funk as well. Cool on the Gang. Fucking Jimmy Cliff. I don't even know what you class this as. It's kind of a soul. Yeah, I like soul music. This is my life. This is a really fucking weirdly catchy song. These
are the voices I long to hear. No matter how far I may roam, I have a home, and I have a home. I have a home, and I have a home. I love our
story. Anyway. You can kind of tell what. Ooh. Hound Dog Taylor. But interestingly, recently, I actually kind of got into kind of rap a little bit. I started listening to Dr. Dre. And I actually really enjoy this. Which is weird, because it doesn't seem like something I'd enjoy at all based on what I like. But like. It's just really, I don't know, I just really like it. It's weird, I think, as I've got older, I think this happens to a lot of people as you get older, I think, because I think when you're teens, it's very much a thing to be into one specific genre of music. And like, days everybody want to talk, like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move the lips, just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre. Days everybody want to talk, like they got something to say, but nothing comes out when they move the lips, just a bunch of gibberish, and motherfuckers act like they forgot about Dre. What is this, somebody I hate? I don't know the rest of the words. But, yeah, as you get older, you sort of, I think, listen to more sort of genres of music, and your taste gets a bit more varied, I think, because yeah, as like a teenager, it's you know, you either like pop or you like, if you're into this pop punk or sort of rock, you're very dedicated to that, I think, as a teenager. I think that happens a lot. I don't know why, but it does. I don't know. I can kind of get why, because, you know, you have the cliques and you have this sort of style you're going for. You know, people like to have this specific style about themselves when they're a teenager. You know, which is, it's fine. It's perfectly fine. Just as you get, I think, as you get a bit older, you sort of stop caring because you don't need to do that anymore. I think that's the main thing, really. Anyway, Hitman. Okay, so if you look at the title, I'm going to do Kill Everything. Sappy Enza. This is interesting. I'm not going to do it in Paris because Paris I don't really think is... practical, because it's just massive crowds of people. I'm not going to be able to kill a massive crowd. I mean, I don't even think I'd have enough ammo to possibly ever kill all the people in Paris, but Sapienza has a lot less people. It's a lot larger and open. There's a lot more secluded places I can get people. So, like, you see, what I want to do is kill everyone. And ideally, I want to do it as many as possible as stealth. Like, I think I'd like to just stealthily kill a bunch of people. As many as I can. who I can get on their own or secluded, and then take out the other groups. Go right, everyone in Paris. God, could you imagine? In your school, you had an unspoken rule that everyone could listen to tape. This will shake it off, but you were not allowed to play it loud enough for other people to hear. The thing is, I like Shake It Off. I like the song Shake It Off. It's just, I don't really like it. But there's a couple of songs I really like. Like, I love Uptown Funk. Uptown Funk is a fantastic buddy song. Because it's Saturday night, man. It's such a fantastically good song. And I think what's so good about that song is that a lot of people, no matter what genre you like of music, even if you're really into pop punk and metal, so many people just like that song because it's just so good. I don't know why it's so good, but it is just really good. And it is very funky. It's like a lot of these, Cool in the Gang songs, but it's got this, rocky pumpiness to it. It's just really good. It's a really good song. Oh, do you like the Hitman game? I love this Hitman game. I absolutely love this Hitman. Like, me and John love this Hitman game, and Dan really doesn't. I think me and John generally share more opinions on games than me and Dan. Me and John have very similar game taste, and Dan is a bit different with it. Bruno Mars is a fantastic musician. I mean, I don't enjoy most of his other music, but I think he is a fantastic musician. Now, I want to kill as many people as possible, so ideally, rapid fire weapon won't be that useful. It'll be useful for gunning down people, but I think if I'm trying to do stuff stealthy, the sniper is going to be better, the silent sniper. I could use the Jaeger Lancer, which has a better zoom, but I can aim with a mouse properly, and I prefer it to be silenced. The breaching charge is to get into the underground lab. I find the breaching charge a lot easier to get in there. I mean, there's other ways to get in depending on where you come in. If you come in from the ruins, you can sort of sneak about pretty easily and in there. But I'd rather take out the town first and then go into the thing. I think that's how I'm going to do it, at least, anyway. Or maybe. Maybe I should start in the ruins, kill everyone in the ruins, work my way into the lab, go through the lab, kill a few people in the lab, work my way back out, and then work my way back into the lab later. That might be easier, actually. Yeah, I'm going to do that. Cool. Right. Obviously, you need the garrote wire. Don't need coins, they're everywhere. Need the breaching charge to get through the thing. I'll do this suit only, why not? Alright, let's do them. Yeah, episodic doesn't really work, but the thing is with this, I've had so much enjoyment out of each level. I don't really like this format, but, I've spent at least 10 hours on each of these levels. Especially, it's weird, because I spent that much time in Paris, but I did a lot of contract and stuff in Paris. But in this, Sappy Enzo, I haven't done a single contract. I've just been doing the main fucking campaign, and I've spent more time than Paris. I've got mastery level 20 on this. I fucking love this. Am I going to MCN Comic-Con now? I really don't like Comic-Cons at all. I don't even get the appeal of Comic-Cons. It's just if you're a cosplayer, I guess, but outside of that, it's just a bunch of fucking stalls of merch. I can just buy things in other places. I don't really know what else you do at those things. I can only kill everyone. Sorry, I'm going to be coughing a lot during this as well. I apologize profusely. Also, the frame rate's going to dip a lot, I'm sorry. I don't know if you'll notice that or not. Also, I'm streaming at a very high... one of the two kind of restraints on the level. The other one is in the hippies room. Yeah, the frame rate dies a lot because in DirectX 11 it doesn't run very well when I'm streaming, especially. I usually do it on DirectX 12, but XBit just cannot pick up DirectX 12. It's still... I thought it would have updated, but it hasn't. It's really annoying. I'm streaming at 3500 kilobits per second. And actually, since I last streamed, when I did the test stream last, I've lowered the encoding, the compression encoding, because you can set it to how much your CPU compresses it. You can set how much it compresses it. I don't have many bullets for that, so. Yeah, you can set how much it compresses it. You've got, encoder presets, so ultra fast, fast, normal, a lot. And depending, the higher it is, the more CPU you're using. But the thing is, I have such high bandwidth that I don't really need to compress it, so I just have it on the fastest I can, which will lower my CPU usage, so hopefully we do stream it, and it'll be better quality. So bitrate is fucked. I don't know what that means. Hang on. I have to check. I'm just having it up on the other computer because the preview never fucking works. I am dying a bit here. It's really blocky when I move. Do you have quality options? Yeah, blocky means it's being compressed. Let's see. Yeah, I have quality options. Hang on. Yeah, this is good. I have quality options today because there's enough people watching. That's nice. I'm just testing this. Does the internet make up for the terrible movie experience? Totally. And all the space in this office as well. Like, this office is huge. And I've just got this massive vibe space. It's full of a lot of boxes right now. Yeah, on a high, it compresses it a lot. If you look at on source, it doesn't. That's interesting. It's compressing it a lot on... it's compressing it quite a lot on high. Also, my fucking... The delay is really low. Oh no, I can see that, yeah. When I move, it sort of goes glig-glig-glig. No, yeah, even on source, it's doing the glig-glig-glig. Yeah, that's weird. I have no idea why it's doing that. Fuck Twitch. I don't know why it's doing that. Report a playback issue. Report playback issue. Audio and video stutter. Video stutters, but audio is fine. Thank you for your report. Great. Let's look at video stats. Jesus. Buffer size. Playback rate is at full. Latency is 10 seconds. The latency to broadcast is 13 seconds. Buffer size is 10 seconds. So we skip 4 frames. Yeah. I just want to go up here and just get this guy out because I don't. It makes me very uncomfortable that he's just here. Basically, I'm trying to get my points as low as possible, even though I know it can't go below zero, but whatever. Yeah, it's when I move, it doesn't. That's Twitch's compression, I think. I don't know why it's doing that. Because on source, it should be streaming it at the exact quality I'm streaming it out at, and I'm not compressing it at all, even. Yeah, it shouldn't look that bad at all, no. But I don't know how it does, because it's not like it's... I'm not compressing it at all. Like, it's on ultra-fast compression, so it shouldn't even be compressing it almost at all. That's very odd. That's very odd. Also, by the way, this is as much of a test stream as yesterday. yeah, it's a lot of OBS problems, but apparently, I'll apply to a thingy. Let's see. Bitrate's fine. Bitrate's really high. Fuck you. Why is my stream so pixelated? Bitrate's too high. Now, the max they accept is 3,500. Apparently. Apparently it doesn't handle 1080p very well. That's why. So, it's like, I'm assuming at 1080, apparently, if you're not partnered, it doesn't handle it well. But I assume it's saying about not being partnered because of the quality options. But I have quality options currently, which is what a partner would have, so it should look fine on source still. Sorry, I'm reading, that's why I'm not talking. Yeah, it's very odd. I mean, if I have quality options, it shouldn't make a difference. Not using them, let's see. If you have it high, it's considered a DDoS, but it's not high enough for that. Yeah, a lot of it's saying, oh, you should be partnered if you want to stream high, but it's, as I say, I'm getting the quality options, so I, Livestream's a pain in the ass, you know. And the 1080p should definitely be fine. And when they're talking about being partnered, they're talking about the quality options, but they can come, even if you're not partnered, if you're just in a hype, in a certain percentage, top percentage of Twitch streamers. So currently I've got 110 viewers, which is reasonably high for me, and it's a Sunday night, so I'm in the top percentage, so I have quality options. So, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna up my bitrate a bit and see what happens. Let's up it to 4,000. Just out of curiosity, I wanna see what happens, if that's gonna improve anything. I don't know if it will, but let's have a test. Let's try. Try setting the compression to slowest. Slowest. Well, that would put a huge drain on my CPU. Wait, well, surely the less it's compressing it, the better it should look, though, right? That's my logic, at least. I'm just testing on 4,000 for a little bit. Let's see what happens. Well, the thing is, I can't change the compression without restarting the stream. Oh, I think that looks a bit worse. Or is it just as bad? God. Fucking Twitch. Yeah, I know, if I put the bitrate too high, it'll start lagging. Well, this is one of with quality options, this is fine. This is why I want to test this now, because if you have issues with bandwidth, go on, medium or low. I don't want to restart the stream if possible. Fuck it, I'll have to restart the stream, I think. That's really annoying that I can't change the preset on the... You know what, I'll restart the stream. I'll be back in, 2 seconds. Okay, so... I am currently streaming using NVIDIA, the NVIDIA thing, instead of the, instead of the normal one, just to test if that's any better. I don't know why the bitrate's so... Oh, there, no, it's back up now. There we go. It was a fucking 300, and now it's... Oh, that's weird. It's going all over the fucking place. Quality looks better, though. It's not blocky when I move. Is that good quality? Do you think it's good quality, or do you just think it's better? Because I want it to be good. I don't want it just to be better. It's still going a bit in and source. Hang on, let's have a move around a bit. It's a bit better. No, it's not doing it nearly as much, but it's still... I think the frame rate's a bit worse. No, it's better, but not good. It doesn't go blocky when I move, but it's a bit better, right? Okay, and NVIDIA one isn't fine, because I can't really... The options for using sort of the NVIDIA thing are basically incredibly limited. Okay. Yeah, the bitrate's fucking going all over the place. I don't know why. It's 400, and then it's up to 30. But it's weird that it looks fine at 300, which is weird. Because it does say I'm streaming at 383 currently, which makes no sense. I'm assuming it's just streaming at a different bitrate based on what's happening on the screen. I think it's probably variable. But it's still odd. Whatever, oh my god, I'll restart the stream again, for God's sake. Okay. See, it's a test. Hey, look, I know I have no idea what I'm doing, but hey, this is why I'm testing. I haven't tested on this good internet, so yes. I've changed the compression. Let's see if that helps. I haven't set it to 2 good, because my CPU struggles a bit. I don't think it's. I should probably upgrade my CPU at some point. It does struggle a bit at let's have a look. It still doesn't look great, does it? The frame rate's a bit fucky, isn't it? It's better though, isn't it? What's my CPU? My CPU is a 3930K. I'm streaming at 1080p currently. Hang on. Oh, shit. I clicked an option on XSplit and it just went off. You'd recommend 720 as opposed to 1080. But surely it shouldn't matter if I'm getting quality options, though. Surely if I've got quality options, it should just be fine. You're getting frame drops. If you're getting frame drops, it's probably because your internet is... Like, I'm not getting any frame drops on my end. I mean, this is the problem with this high bitrate. It fucks people over with internet connections of most kinds. Where the fuck are these guys? I'm just sort of half playing the game. I'm just going to walk around for a bit and see what that's like. I'm just going to use this for a tiny little bit of time. Tell me, and after a while, if some of you can give me nice criticisms and complaints and... complaints, probably just entirely complaints, probably, I mean. If your compression is slow, it's hard on your CPU. Well, that's the problem. I'm trying to avoid that because I know when I tried having it high, slow, it just really fucking, like, lagged a lot of prop things. I mean, it looks kind of pretty alright on my end. Looking at it in Source on my other computer. It's a bit blocky, though. It doesn't look 1080. It looks kind of low res, doesn't it? I mean, although keep in mind, make sure you're on Source because the if it's on high or something, it will be just compressing it. I can't kill those guys yet. I want to take out all the people on their own first. Are you using Paris? Oh, that's an idea. I'm using automatic. I don't know. I do not know what ingest server I'm using. I assume it'll be using London by default, surely. If that's the one I'm closest to. I don't know how to check when it's on. I have no idea how to actually test if it's there. Or check which one it's on before, unless I restart the stream again. If you're on Source and the frame rate's still shit. It says it's 30, but I think XSplit's... The frame rate is. I think that's XSplit stuttering. Like, looking at my XSplit window, that's XSplit stuttering, not actually the game or Twitch. That's XSplit having a little go. It'll be a lot of it will be stuttering on you lot's end, but currently it is dropping. It is lagging a little bit through XSplit. You can see there it's a bit jittery. And that's XSplit. Not. I don't think that's. That's XSplit not handling impression very well. Oh dear. One of my lighthouses on the other side of the room, my oh shit, hang on. Hang on, wait. Sorry. I set up my HTC Vive lighthouses in the corners of my room. I just put them up with sticky back tape, normal tape. They stay up for like a day, and then they just start slowly falling off. And I saw the one in the other corner of the room just sort of half fell off and was stuck on by a tiny bit of tape, and I just wanted to take it down so it didn't fall down horribly. It's really annoying, these lighthouses. They didn't really provide a way to mount them without, like, drilling into the wall. I mean, I know you can put them on stands, but they're really annoying. Just give me some actual good way to mount into the wall. Because, fucking, I'm in a rated place. I can't just drill into the fucking wall. Well. Oh, God, I didn't even pause the game. I was just hanging there the whole time. Thankfully, nobody looks up. Oh, shit, no. Crouch. Fucking crouch. I forgot to crouch. Hey. Shit. I forgot how to crouch very briefly there. Fuck. Bollocks. Thankfully, nobody heard me. I'm just thinking of all the guns I find, by the way, just because I'm sure I'll run out of ammo on this eventually. It's shift button. I panicked. Shut up. Are you streaming from the same PC the game is? Yeah, I am. I am streaming from the same PC the game's on. I think, because the game was running fine. It's running at, you know, 58, 59 FPS. You know, it's not lagging in game. It is. It's just the exploit window seems to be a bit shit to a blue tack. I don't think, no. What was the lighthouses are quite heavy, and when they're on, they kind of spin. There's something inside them that's spinning. It's like when they were and they vibrate, and I think if they weren't vibrating, they probably would be all right. I think it's the fact they're vibrating which causes some problems. I think they just slowly because of vibrate themselves off whatever sticky stuff they're on, lowering game resources to leave more resources to exploit. Well, this is the problem. I kind of don't want to do that. I'd rather them just like this is what I want to have them running at high, and you know. Like, this is the thing, I want to get the balance. I don't want to have to lower it in-game, because the whole reason I want it to look good is because, you know. Come on. It's weird, that makes no noise, nobody hears that. It's really strange. Also, it annoys me, they give you two, and I'm glad they do, because it doesn't work half the fucking time. There's some times where I've tried to come through this way, and they just... It hasn't worked. Both of them have just not worked, even when they've been right next to it. It's really annoying. Some tripods are taller. I'm using X264. I tried via ENC, and it was a bit worse. Okay. Ooh. It's weird. Those people are suspicious of me. Most other people are suspicious of me, but these guys aren't. That's the end of the, oh no, those guys are. This is the problem. With this, is that getting people on their own is going to be a bit of a problem. These people. Fuck. More frame drops. Entering the ether lab requires I mean, obviously my stream quality wasn't great before, but that was because of the internet. Now the internet's not an issue, so I'm trying to obviously resolve. I'm trying to make it so I can stream good. Okay. This is how I'm going to have to take people out, just a lot. It's people like going to get them with the sniper. Yeah, no, if it's frame dropping for you, honestly, it's probably your end. Just because the bitrate's too high for you to keep up with. Eliminate. Oh my god. That's not what I meant to do. I ignored the push button. Oh yeah, the Batman smoke. Yeah, but the Batman smoke was dropping my frame rate in game. It was dropping my frame rate in game to 40 from 60, and I was streaming at 60. This, I'm streaming at 30, and the frame rate's pretty much at a constant 50, 60. So, try streaming at 720, 60. I mean, I don't know if 60 is really worth it, honestly. I don't think a lot of games, especially when streaming, a lot of games sort of dip to 50. I think probably 30 just works better, I think. I mean, I wouldn't mind 60, but until I get a better computer that can actually run 60 constantly. I need to get rid of these two twats in here. Why would you stream it? I mean, there's obviously advantages. It's the same reason you'd stream it takes you, the same reason you'd watch a YouTube video at 60 FPS, because some people just prefer it. But I don't think it adds a lot to some streams. And I think it's often a detriment. If my frame rate drops a little bit, it's noticeable and all that. What's my bit rate at? My bit rate is at 3,500. My buffer's at 2, like Twitch says. It's all Twitch specific setting. It's all the max Twitch settings. My audio bit rate's 160, which is the max Twitch setting. My oh shit, people walking here, don't they? Motherfucker. Why don't you look at the ocean? It's just fine. Yeah, the frame rate drops. Oh shit. What body got found? Who found a body? Oh. Oh shit. Who noticed the crime? Oh fuck, it's shit. Fuck. Fine. Fuck it. It's fucked up. There's no slow time kill everyone button in this one like there wasn't fucking Absolution. Bollocks to it. Motherfucker. I didn't want to get noticed because it's it fucking might alert the target and then I'll be fucked. Fuck, don't report it. There we go. Fuck, hunted, motherfucker. Disguise. I don't want a disguise, but fuck it. Okay, now I can walk around with my gun out as well. Shit. Okay. Try 1440. You know, I could totally try 1440 and that'd be a terrible idea. Let's go in the sewers and kill Mario. Go with resolution to 720. I think a good quality 720 stream would be better than a slightly lower quality 1080 stream. I think that would be generally advantageous. Who the fuck noticed that? Who would possibly have noticed? Oh shit, he noticed it. He noticed him being shot in the head. Oh shit, I didn't bring a fucking lockpick. Goodbye, Art. Fuck your name. So many people, like, so many people's usernames are fucking unpronounceable to me. It's really annoying. maybe Twitch isn't ready. A lot of people stream at these good qualities, though. It's not like I'm a rare case or anything. You know what's funny? You say you like me because I swear a lot, but have I sweared, like, once? I haven't swore once in this stream, I don't think. I like all these targets just can't swim either. All these people can't swim. It makes no sense. Almost everyone streams at 720 60. Really? That's interesting. Because I thought more people would prefer the higher resolution because, you know, most people will have 1080p displays. Well, maybe not most people, but, you know, a lot of people have 1080p displays. So, it's, I think, interesting. I'll try restarting the stream in a few minutes and I'll try 720 60. See how that goes. Oh no, don't notice the body, Oh hey. Alrighty. Nope, bollocks. Nope, 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 nope. Fuck. What do you mean? How did he know I was disguised? What if I was just a fucking... Why do you... I hate that they sort of like, oh, no, he's disguised. How the fuck do you know? How do you know I'm just not a security guard killing someone? It's flawless when I look towards the sea. But yeah, the frame rate goes directly to 60 when it's I'm looking at the sea. Perfect 60. When I look here, it's I'm sort of at 50. It's the priest. I mean, no one's going to recognize me here. Ah, fuck off. I can get most of these guys secluded. The gardener. Most of them are sort of on their own, really. Match your buffer to your stream. What do you mean? Your stream is 720 at 60. Well, yeah, that's fair enough. I think a lot of people have 1080p. Like, a lot of people have 1080p displays right now. It's not really... He died from that. That very short, small fall he died from. 780p60. Well, this is the problem. Like, compromise. Like, I don't have...
That's new.
Oh, damn it. Yeah, I think it's like this isn't going to run at 60. Like, it's running at 30 now. But obviously the hope is there that, you know, you wouldn't really notice it was running at 30 because,
Sir, this is off limits.
Nope, nope. Oh my god, really? How many people watch Twitch full screen? That's a good point. How many people do watch Twitch full screen? You know what, I'm going to buffer to 3.5k, match your bitrate. Alright, okay, you know what, I'm going to restart the stream, change the buffer, change the resolution, and I'll be back. Right, so, I had a mess, I tested a lot of stuff, I hope this works. It's 720, it's 720p, 60fps. I'm streaming to a different ingest server. I'm streaming to Amsterdam instead of London. See if that makes a difference. Bandwidth, the bitrate's still 3,500 kilobits per second. The buffer is exactly the same as that. Everything should be working, in theory. But it's streaming. Basically, that was my second lighthouse falling down behind me. That's good. If you didn't say it was 720, you wouldn't notice. Well, that's the thing. If you're watching in a window, which most people who watch Twitch are, unless you're on multiple monitors, then even if you're on a 1080p display, you're probably only watching it at 720 anyway. So... Let's try streaming at this for a bit and see how it fares. I'm in the tunnels now. Should be able to fucking... Oh, there he is. The little twat. I mean, the red plumber. Is he allowed to carry... he's not allowed to carry weapons. Amazingly. Problem is now, since it's a 60... You're gonna notice the frame drops. Cause I don't know if you can tell. If you look in the very top left of the screen, you can see my frame rate. I mean, like, that's the Steam built-in frame counter. It's a really nice frame counter because I hate the fucking the other ones are really big and they're yellow and they're green. This one's a really subtle one on the top left corner that if you're playing a game, you can just completely ignore it. And I just like to check it. No one seems to notice it. It's not running at 60 FPS solid because I'm not running at 60 FPS solid. You can tell that in the top there. And that's because on DirectX 11, this was when I'm streaming, it doesn't run very well. If we're streaming at DirectX 12, it'd look fine. But XSplit can't pick up DirectX 12, which is really annoying. So, oh shit, he was faster than I thought he was. Oh, fuck, no, die. Didn't give me the option to fucking kill the priest, it's fine. The frame rate jitter hasn't changed. It's jittering, is it? I'm streaming to Amsterdam. It did say one of the things. It's like, ooh, jitter 2 milliseconds. I don't know what that means. The London one had none, but 60 looks like 60, but it still drops a lot. Let's try this for a bit and see how it fares. Might as well have, might as well. I mean, it does look a bit better. I mean, the colours are a bit off. Well, that's expert doing it. I don't know, the colours are a little off. They're a bit too yellowy, I think. Yeah, they're a bit too. Yeah, they need to be a bit more like, I don't know, it's like got a yellow tint to it. It's weird. Turn the contrast up a bit. Down a bit now. Turn it down a little bit. Turn the brightness up a bit. Oh god, that's even worse. What did I do? Oh god. Ah. It looks shitter than a low frame rate because it randomly stops for a few frames. That's on your end. Probably. My mic went up 50%. Ah, you should. Well, there we go. Click full range. Yeah, full range seems to make it worse. Makes it darker, but it needs to be whiter and less yellowed. I don't know why it's. Oh, God. Ah, oh dear. Well, that's Hue. Well, there we go. That'll work. Joker vision. Yeah. Jesus. Oh, that'll do. Whatever. Screw it. What am I. Hmm. Ah, I've got two priest outfits just in case. Yeah, let's try this for a bit. Just if you see a problem, tell me what it is very specifically. Tell me what it is. Don't be vague with it. You need to, if you see like if it's dropping frames or it's whatever, like if you're trying to help as well, like have a look at the if you right click it and look at stats, video stats, you can see if skipped frames, like I'm seeing, yeah, is it? I'm seeing skipped frames on Twitch's end, when I'm looking at the stream, on my other computer, which is odd because I wasn't getting that with the London server, but now I am. But I don't know if that's because I'm, I don't know if that's literally because the game is running at, you know, 58, 56 FPS when I'm streaming at 60, and maybe that's why it's actually skipping frames, because there are, the game is literally skipping frames. I don't know. Skip frames 170. So it's just dropping off of me. It says it's dropping about, ooh. Yeah, 2 and then 6 and then 2 and then 6. So. I mean, I could stream at 30. 720 30, I'll probably be fine. But just a higher bit rate. I wish it didn't compress it as much. It really annoys me. Like, you'd think source would be literally what I'm seeing. Because, like, I suppose if it's without a dedicated server or anything, I know the Ogcast, Twitch give the Ogcast a dedicated server for their, you know, charity streams. But obviously without that, my ingest is a little too high, isn't it? Let's kill these guys in the dock. Lock guns. I can't fucking see them. Oh, come. Motherfucker. Guards alerted. What do you mean? What? They alerted to what? That someone got shot on the head. Boo hoo. Oh, come on. Come on. No. Stop. You've been shot twice, woman. Stop. Fuck. I like that they basically instantly know where you are as well. I shouldn't be using all my fucking ammo on this thing. In that guy, I'd love to take that guy out, but that's a waste of shot, because you can easily, basically pretty much always get him without fire. This is why I don't go for the two-time sniper, because I can easily snipe anyone anyway. I don't need the 2x scope. I might as well just fucking use the this one and have it silenced. It's not as powerful, but the other one, you use it and fucking everyone hears it in a 3 mile fucking radius. It's running a shit ton smoother. Well, up there it probably is, but like it's running at 45 FPS now. And the game is just dropping because when I'm streaming, it's going to drop. And fucking, it's going to drop because it's running a DirectX 11, which is just the game runs a lot worse in DirectX 11 than it is in DirectX 12. So. I know that doesn't really help, I'm still carrying guns, but you know, it's better than nothing. It doesn't make me instantly compromised when they see me, they just... Oh shit! Fuck. Oh, Jesus, I didn't even fucking see him. Bloody hell. Right, fuck. Luckily he was the only guard, apparently. Oh, I can't really hide his body, can I? Stream is running smoother. See, is this a CPU issue? Is this literally just my CPU having issues? Oh shit! Fuck! I didn't mean to use this. I didn't mean to use this gun. Fuck! I meant to use my science gun. Oh, bollocks to it! Bollocks! 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 Just hide up here and shoot everyone. I want to point out that I did sort of. This machine is getting on a bit, so perhaps, I don't know, perhaps it just, maybe the 3930 just can't keep up with rendering a game and rendering the thing at the same time. But this is the point, like, but not using it back your hand with CPU. Well, this is why I put it on ultra fast, because surely even on ultra fast it shouldn't even compress the damn thing. As long as I have the bandwidth, it should be fine, but it's not. It's really odd. No, it must be the CPU. I mean, this is one of the things that's like, I think my graphics card's fine. The CPU feels like something I should really upgrade, but the thing that always puts me off upgrading the CPU is it's not like a graphics card, you can't just buy another one and stick it in, you have to fucking buy another motherboard. And the new motherboard's a DDR4 RAM, so I'd have to buy a new RAM as well. I just have to rebuy everything, pretty much, and I don't really want to do that. It's quite expensive to replace all my fucking components. So I'd rather avoid it if I can. It just really annoys me because. The Windows just doesn't handle resources as well as it could. This is from my just experience of using a fucking Mac. The Mac just handles its hardware resources extraordinarily well. Like that's why I can render a video 3 times as fast on a Mac that's underpowered from this. You know, I can use 8 gigs of RAM on that thing. It's fine. Could I not push my video to the Mac? Yeah, but then I need no, because the Mac doesn't have a capture card in and. I can't do and I'd have to use OBS on the Mac, and OBS is shit. Well, this is Sapienza, yeah. This is Sapienza, it's just a part of Sapienza you might not have been in before. Let's beat her over the head. Come on, beat her up. Hello? Jesus. Fucking hell. I bet no one heard her screams for help. OBS is not shit. For me, it's shit. FME on the Mac. I haven't heard of that before. No, look, OBS is fine for a lot of people, but for what I like, it's not good. It's... Oh, shit. It takes a lot more time to add... sources, I just don't like it. I don't like using it. It's not bad, I just for when I use XSplit 4, I don't like it. FME. I'll flash me your code. I could, but once again, I don't have a capture card on the Mac. I'd have to get an external capture card, and fuck that. I mean, the amount of money I'd spend getting it all hooked up to the Mac, and also, I wouldn't be able to do, because, you know, if I tab out of this game, and I open up another window, and I whatever, do, like, you still just see only the game, because it's just capturing the executable, as opposed to connecting, as opposed to the whole monitor, which I like a lot more, because it gives you a lot more freedom to just do shit. Because if every time I tapped out, my fucking Windows bar would come up. I had this issue in the, the recent Fluster Clock. In that, I recorded it using the NVIDIA thing, Shadowplay. But what I've done is, Shadowplay I have set by default to desktop capture, because it, from recording something on there anyway, I'm usually only doing those. But I recorded it, but I tap out a lot during streams, so there's a lot of times when the taskbar comes off, and I had to edit those out cleverly. Well, I say cleverly, but I had to sort of, yeah. So I'd like to preferably find a way to just do it all through the PC. Maybe I should invest in upgrading it. I think the processor is. It's a good processor, and it's still fine for gaming on its own. But if you're trying to do both. Nobody notices, he's just sleeping, don't worry. Oh, come on, I shot you three fucking times. Four times. Oh, I shot her in the head as well. Fuck off. Fuck off, you get up after that. I think I'm collecting more ammo for this thing as well. So my plan is to, I'll work my way through the town, kill everyone in the town, and then go into the mansion. Because I think that it's nice having the separate areas in this mission. Okay. That's why you won't get into gaming, it's so expensive. It's very expensive. Very expensive to do PC gaming. Well, it's quite expensive. It's quite time-consuming and expensive to do PC gaming. But to do just console gaming, it's fine. That's why a lot of people do console gaming, because it's just a lot more accessible. It's a hugely more accessible just to do console gaming. Oh, God. You know, when you shoot someone fucking three times in the chest, they usually go down. I shot him in the fucking head, he didn't. Fuck, don't kill me, you fucking kill me. Fuck. Find another of this guy. Oh, fuck. Fuck. Your PS3 broke. PS3 is an over. I mean, the current gen consoles are actually pretty reliable. I haven't really heard any kind of big, sort of technical issues with the PS4 or the X1. They both seem to have worked pretty well. So the thing is, right, my old streams was kind of fine, but it's because I kind of got used to it. But I want to figure out how to do the streaming at the high bit rate properly before Wednesday on the podcast, because I'd like to have that all nice and good. Compromised, fucking hell. That's the detective. Ooh. I really like the detective because he can see through every disguise because he's a detective. Because he's such a good detective, he can see through every disguise. And I really like the sort of silliness of that. Like, he's never met you before, but he can see the barcode. He's the only person in the fucking game that can see the fucking barcode on your damn head. Nobody saw. You ain't seen nothing. You ain't seen nothing, Jimmy.
No.
Alrighty. There's the detective. Alrighty. Isn't the podcast a static overlay? It is, but I'd still like to. I don't know, I'd like to. Especially before the. I mean, maybe not necessarily before the but definitely before the fluster clock. Fluster clock. Fluster clock. I don't know. But what's fucking? I fucking own basically all the fucking. I own a Wii U and a fucking. I own a Wii U and a PS4 and an Xbox 360. You know, I think consoles are fucking fine and great and good. It depends what you want. This is the key thing. It's not a mutually exclusive thing. Different things are for different people. Consoles are very nice because they're basically plug and play. You know, I mean, I think recent newer consoles are a bit worse for that, just because, you know, you have to download updates and shit. But, you know, old consoles especially, where you just put the disc in and it works. The Wii U still does that. The idea of putting a disc in and it working is great. You know, on PC, you have to spend ages downloading it, mess with a load of graphic settings, some day one issues, you know, fucking a lot of faff involved. But, I mean, I know some people try to make it, like, Nvidia has the thing where they will set your graphics settings automatically, recommended optimal settings for AAA games, which is a good thing. It's trying to make it a bit more console-like, which is quite nice. Oh, shit. Oh. I got so far. But in the end, it doesn't even matter. Okay, so, what set, I can restart the stream now again, if, I mean, is there anything I should change, do you think? Is there anyone have any suggestions? Oh yeah, the Vive is just such a unique experience. I mean, the Move is similar to that. I mean, the Move is, it's like the DK2, but with Vive functionality, but it's obviously still quite limited in its scope. But yeah, consoles are not necessarily high end, but you buy consoles are convenient. It's convenience over fucking performance. I mean, but this is the thing as well. You hate minimizing graphical settings. This is an interesting point. Well, a lot of people go, "Oh, it looks better on PC," but most people have PCs that look about as good as a console. I mean, although most people on PC, they aim for 60 as opposed to 30. So. If you use a lower CPU preset. I was, and people were complaining. Maybe I should try. I mean, it's on very fast. It's on, what's it on? It's on very fast currently. I could set it to ultra fast, but I think that was what was causing the issues before. Don't know what else I can do, really. I'm gonna up the bitrate a bit and just see what happens. I know I probably shouldn't do that, but I'd like to try anyway. Well, so thanks for sticking around if you're still here, but fucking, oh, I've got 47 viewers. Nobody leave or fucking join. 47 viewers is perfect. Fuck. And I don't think the stealth approach worked. There's too many people in too many spaces. I can't. I can't. Let's go to TAC9. TAC9, the explosive duck. I think that'll be good, yeah. I mean, yeah, 60 FPS is a bit problem. Lowering game settings. You know what? I'll try and lower in game settings just as a test. I don't want to have to do that, because I just don't like doing that normally, and it's annoying to have to lower in game settings every time. I'm not lowering the anti aliasing. Fuck off. Let's just lower things a little bit and see what happens, shall we? Did that? I don't know if that even lowered them. It's running at 60 seemingly constantly now, though, so I assume it did something. Am I supposed to? No, it's not. It did low. It did lower than though. That's interesting. Actually, it doesn't ask me to. It's applied. Maybe I have to restart the game. I don't know. The frame rate's still dropping a bit. Let's put it on the lowest fucking setting. I keep saying let's, like you're fucking taking part. I'm doing this on my own, leave me be. Trilinear motherfucker. 59. Everything looks terrible. Everything looks actually terrible. And, still dropping to 50. 40. Yeah, the drops I'm getting seem to... Oh, I can test this. I'm going to open a window. Let's see. Yeah, the drops I'm getting don't seem to be graphical. Or caused by graphics. Like, the thing is, I always look for a CPU bottleneck. Because, you know, if your CPU is bottleneck, it'd be running at 100%. But it's only running at 60% my CPU. Which implies that's not a bottleneck. So clearly, the bottleneck, the dropping of the frames on this isn't caused by the graphical settings, it's caused by something else, but I don't know what the bottleneck is. I mean, it does look a bit better because it isn't dropping as much. It isn't dropping to, you know, 45, or it isn't dropping to 55, you know. I imagine some of the drops are slightly graphical, but the rest, it is still dropping a lot. Like, it's running at 60 now. Let's try it for a bit at 60. 59, 60. Yeah, it's so stabilized now. That's interesting. If you look that way. 46. There we go. 40. Yeah. It's dropping a bit. But it's dropping about as much as it would on thingy. But usually at sort of very high, it'd run at, you know, 55 and it dropped to 40. But now it's running at 60 and dropping to... So it is still dropping about the same amount of frames. It's just I'm having a higher average frame rate. My RAM is currently... I'm using 11 gigs of RAM out of 32. I'm using 40% of my CPU. My discs are fine. Ethernet is unstrained. I'm sending 5 megabits a second when I can send like fucking 1,000. I mean, this is kind of annoying to me. Hitman is using 33% CPU. Expert's using 4% CPU. I'm going to be back in a second. I'm going to try something. Yeah, a lot of the frame drops you lot are seeing are on your end. Especially now, because I don't think there's any quality options anymore. Yeah, I don't think there's quality options anymore. Maybe there is, I don't know. Either way, a lot of the frame drops some of you'll be seeing will be on your end, just because I'm streaming at such a high bit rate. Okay, what I've done is I've changed the server back to London, and I'm streaming at 30. Now it said, no, I still have quality options. That's incredible. I still have quality options with only 40 viewers. I've loaded it to 30. I have upped the compression significantly. I've upped it to medium from fast, just to see what happens, to see how it handles it. I mean, the expert window looks smoother, weirdly, which is incredible. An expert broadcaster, the thing is, experts, even with this high compression, it's only using 5% of my CPU. It looks kind of shitter on Twitch's end. That looks definitely shitter. It looks fuzzier, doesn't it? It looks smoother because it's at 30 FPS. So when I'm dropping frames, you're not noticing. That's sort of half the point. But, I mean, I... Yeah, you see, I'm dropping, like, to 40 there, but you're not going to notice that. It does look worse, doesn't it? It's smoother. It's a lot smoother. But the quality is worse because I'm compressing it more. This is the thing. Like, a lot of people are saying, oh, put the compression really high. But yeah, but it'll just make it look worse. I'm actually, hang on, fucking, I'm gonna fucking restart the stream again. I'm sorry for restarting the stream so much. And a lot of people are leaving because of it. Sorry. But, hey. Yeah, the fucking Extreme Rules kickoff show. Who gives a shit about the kickoff show? I'll be back in a second. Ah. Oh, that's terrible, isn't it? Oh, that's dropping frames all over the damn place. But that's because my CPU usage is a lot higher. I know XSplit, the process, actually isn't what actually uses CPU. It's VH multi-writer extension. So as I'm walking and turning, that's going up a lot. Yeah, I'm maxing out my CPU now. It does look nicer though, doesn't it? The actual quality of the pitch is nicer. God, I hate streaming. See, it's great because when you record a video, you just stick it to higher settings, it's fine, and then you edit it. No issues. But this, it's a fucking piece of shit, like the game's dropping more frames because it's getting CPU bottlenecked now. Put the stream again. I mean, it's okay-ish, but it's just fucking dropping frames a lot. Yeah, I just want to see what happens when I put it slowest. Okay, I'll be back in a sec, Jesus. So I'm sorry for the cough. If you didn't know, I was really sick the other week. And I'm mostly recovered. My throat's a little bit hooky, but the only thing left is a bad cough. Okay. It's really annoying. I wish XSplit let you mess with more quality options on the fly, because it's really annoying having to like restart your stream every fucking time you want to test something different. Okay, this is a different compression rate, and yes, that looks smooth. That looks very smooth in the XSplit window. My CPU usage is hovering about 60%. That's a good rate. Looks very smooth in the XSplit window, actually. Oh, the quality looks shit though on the fucking video and the fucking stream. Why? It's all fuzzy and shit. Which is weird though, because surely if it's compressing it less, it should look better. Surely. Right? Surely. 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 I'm gonna up the bitrate massively, like to like 5,000. I know Twitch can consider a DDoS, it's above a certain amount, but what, fuck it, let's just see. I'm just curious to what happens when I try streaming this, if it actually improves it at all or not. No fucking difference. No fucking difference whatsoever. Jesus. But when I said I was professional. Look, this is a test stream. It does say that in the title, in fairness. This is me testing. This isn't fucking meant to be professional. Yeah, nothing changed. I saw the bitrate go up on my other computer on the stats page, but it didn't do it. It didn't seem to change the quality at all. So... it's not the game. It's not the game. The game looks fine on my end. The game looks perfectly fine on my end. This is the thing. Like it looks fine on my end. It's the XSplit window. It lags a bit, but that's fine. But it's the quality of it's the fuzziness. It's the compression. That's the problem. At least to me, it's the compression that's the problem. You know what? I'm just gonna fucking shoot my way out of here. Oh, I have very few bullets for this. They don't want to die. Oh, I'm dead. Okay. You don't forget. Actually, let's try another game. Out of curiosity. Maybe it's the game. And it's weird, the fucking compression options as well, because you have faster, which is like third to top, and then you've got medium, and then you've got slow. And faster's only using like fucking 10%, 30% of my CPU. But then slow is using like fucking 50, 70% of my CPU. So the fucking spikers, the curve is huge at the end. I don't know why. Now let's just... Let's try something nice. Let's try fucking, what's a good old Unity game? What's a good quality? You know what? Oh, fuck. I know. I know what's a nice, low, well-optimized game. Well done if you've stayed this whole time. We've lost like 70 people, but 30 of you are still here. Which is very nice of you. Oh, I haven't run this game on this computer before, apparently. Oh dear, it's running at really low resolution. That's really loud as well, good lord. fucking, I noticed this, right? You know when you open the lab on the Vive? Like, oh my god, they have that. They have like a fucking VR version of the Valve intro. You're just in this VR room full of fucking Valves, and I always hate that intro because it always freaks me the fuck out. I don't know why. Fuck's sake. Oh my god, stop. It really freaks out your monitors when you want something at a low resolution like this. Because it's not detecting my monitor resolution, so it's really get like fucking... some really fucking low. It's running at fucking the low. Like, 1176 by 6640. For some reason, even though it knows my native resolution, and it doesn't run at my native resolution for some reason. This is Portal, by the way. I know this will run great. Because it's a fucking... Source game. It's an older game, so it'll fucking run like with no problem whatsoever, and it'll not cause any problems. So if it's still stuttering on this game, I'll definitely know it's XSplit, not the game. Okay. I'm just seeing my options for it, just so it's cool. Okay, don't right, add to expert. Sorry, I know this isn't that entertaining, but you're helping out with Nerdcubed streams in the future. That's what I tell myself all every night. All every night. Good fucking job. Right. Oh god, I've still got all the Digihon games on my fucking computer. Like, all those fucking digital homicide games. Like, I keep getting emails from them as well. From fucking, about new games they released or whatever. I need to fucking lower the fucking sensitivity and, how do I... Oh, is there no field of view slider? Oh, I don't remember. I played this when I played. Oh, there it is. Fuck. Oh, it goes up to 90. Boo. I like my field of view about 105, which sounds quite high to a lot of people. But when you're using a big monitor like this, it sort of needs to be high. So the mouse is really fucking sensitive for some reason. Oh, that'll do. That looks shit. Oh my god, sorry, the mouse is fucking killing it. Oh, it's got mouse acceleration on. Right. Why was I lowering the mouse acceleration? I'm a fucking idiot. The field of view is really high and it fucking looks like shit. It looks like shit in game, doesn't it? It actually looks worse. It's interesting. God, I hate that song. I don't hate that song, it's a great song, but you know. You're gonna be getting a Vive when moving into a new house. to any advice. Secure the fucking lighthouse as well. Make sure you have no obstructions above you. Like, hanging lights and shit are a problem. Ideally, just remove the fucking hanger. Like, I got really lucky with this place. It's got big, very tall ceiling, and all the lights are these, you know, the faded sort of spotlight things, so they don't hang down at all. Which is very nice. So, oh my god. Oh my god. Oh, Jesus. Whoa. That is the most sensitive ever. Jesus Christ. Okay. Mouse sensitivity is very high. Jesus Christ. Oh god, because it's on fucking high. Oh, okay. Oh, calm down, calm down, calm down, buddy. There we go. Ooh. Bloody hell. Jesus Christ. Oh, bloody. Usually it's fine in most games, and this is giving me problems, whatever that'll do. Yeah, the van's really good. I mean, it's just, the problem I've had putting up here is the lighthouses just keep falling off the fucking walls unless you drill them in. And I'm in a rated place, so I can't drill them in. I mean, I'm very tempted to just, I mean, obviously with a rated place, as long as you fucking repair them when you leave, you can. So I probably will drill them in and just fill them with polyfiller when I leave. Because the walls are VR, so, yeah. Yeah, just looking at the video, like, I can't even read the text. I think it's because it's running. Obviously, I'm running the game at 1440 and the stream at 720, so it's everything's up. Every pixel's up. Maybe that's why. Maybe it's because I'm running the games at too high a resolution for the what I'm streaming. Because maybe that's why it's looking bad. Because it's not downscaling well. That might be it. That might explain everything, actually. Okay. Let's, fucking... hate everything. Fucking, I wanna... Jeez, there we go, bloody hell. Okay. Right, Windows 720. So, I mean, in theory, this should look better. Because it's not having to downscale it, it's just running. It's just running it at the resolution that... Oh my god, it keeps... The mouse wasn't locking... No, the mouse doesn't... The mouse doesn't lock to the win... Why does the mouse not lock to the win? This is a shit game. Fuck me. I keep... I mean, let's see how it looks. It looks worse. Why is streaming so complicated? Why can't you just go, I want it really high quality, boop, and it work? I can't. Okay, I'm going to restart the stream one more time. I want to try something else, and then I'm going to finish. Thanks for sticking around this long, if you're trying to help. I'm back in a sec. I've lowered the resolution of the... I've lowered the resolution of the sort of... I can't remember what it's called. The actual XSplit window, not the stream, but the actual XSplit window to 720p30, the same as I'm streaming at. Also, I realised that I think the reason it looked kind of worse at 1080 is because obviously 4040 scales a lot better to 720, because 4040 is just 4720, so it's one pixel, there's four pixels, it's 1080, it's not the same. So that might be why. I should Rocket League, because I know Rocket League runs really well. Just fucking... What the fuck? Hoops? What the fuck is hoops? The fuck is hoops? I haven't played this for a long time. Wasteland. Ooh. 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 What are these? Ooh. Ooh. Sorry. I got very excited suddenly. Oh my god, mutators. What the fuck? What the bollocks? What the... Gravity. Oh my god, I can have really low gravity. Yes. Fucking ace. Okay. Cool. Oh god, look at this fucking basketball. Jesus. Right. Another game runs well. So, it's the thing with XSplit is it's when it handles, it's how it handles speed. And changing of sort of camera. Oh my god. Fuck the boost. The gravity's really low and the boost is 10 times unlimited. So, fucking Jesus. I can't control anything. So, the stream quality doesn't look that bad. It still looks a bit compressed. Even on source, it looks... I don't want it to look compressed, is the thing. I have the bandwidth that it should... I should be able to have it look like a high-quality YouTube video, in theory. And if it's streaming at that bandwidth anyway, I don't know what the problem is. Fucking dickhead. I think the last time I actually played this was... On a fluster clock. Never stop boosting. It's always going to look compressed. Oh, that annoys me, though. Why? If I'm streaming at high quality anyway, what's the problem? Like, if I'm streaming at this quality anyway, then I don't know why I shouldn't be able to just... really kind of annoying to me. It just doesn't do high quality. It should, though. It really, really should. I'm so tempted to stream on YouTube. I think Dan was not tempted to stream on YouTube as well, because Twitch have been a bit iffy lately with stuff. The problem with YouTube is streaming on YouTube is because it's got the live content ID thing, and one of the things I really like about Twitch is like sharing, like showing off music, and it, like it's a lot. I kind of like it because you can do the copyrighted stuff. I have no control. You can do the copyrighted stuff; it's not really an issue, and you can just have like do silly fun. You can't do that on YouTube, but I imagine YouTube will be higher quality. And it kind of annoys me as well with Twitch, because Twitch, I think, got bought out by, it was Yahoo, wasn't it? Was it Yahoo? Yeah, Yahoo bought. Bloody. Am I wrong? Dan isn't allowed to stream on YouTube, is he, because of his Twitch contract? No, well, of course he can. He just can't stream on YouTube and Twitch at the same time. If you're streaming on Twitch, you can't stream that stream anywhere else, but you can stream wherever the fuck you want to. It's not like it's a mutual thing. Amazon. I thought that was the rumor. I just think I remember that was the rumor and someone else bought them. Maybe I'm remembering wrong. You'll have live YouTube comments. Well, that's just the Twitch chat. That's all it is. It's just the Twitch chat, but different. I mean, the Twitch chat, I mean, people say it like fucking YouTube comments are terrible. Twitch chat's also fucking terrible. It's fine on streams like this, and it would be, the YouTube chat would also be fine on streams like this. It's not like the fucking Twitch chat is any better. Yahoo owned Tumblr. Oh, maybe that's where I got confused. Okay, fine. If Amazon bought... I just thought there was rumours. What was the rumour? Was it the rumour that Google was going to buy Twitch? I think that was the rumour, wasn't it? And then Amazon bought it and kind of surprised people. But you'd think, if Amazon bought Twitch, right... You'd think they'd improve their service. But Twitch don't seem to have improved their service like at all since getting acquired by Amazon. You think with Amazon's vast fucking resources, vast resources and server resources, that they just, you know, figure it out. But they haven't improved it at all. And it's really annoying because, I mean, Twitch is great in a lot of ways because it's this really nice open platform. It's the same reason I quite like the sort of open podcast RSS format that Apple has never changed. They've never changed it. They, you know, Apple changed a lot of things, but they've always kept the podcasts the same, the standard RSS, even with all the modernization. They've always kept it like that. And a lot of people complain about that because they can't monetize them properly and they can't track them properly. But, you know, you don't get all the analytics you'd get on YouTube or something like that. But I think that's one of the nice things about them. Fuck. But I can't control myself in it. Fucking Twitch. But it's just, do people care that much about quality? Because I care a lot about quality. Twitch partners agreed to stream exclusively on Twitch. That can't be true. That can't be true. Because I've seen so many Twitch partners just streaming other places. Like, fucking, you say stream on Twitch, like, fucking, what? If you stream on fucking Periscope, you're breaking contract. Like, I swear it was just you can't stream at the same time on two platforms. Like, if you're streaming something on Twitch, you can only stream it on Twitch, but if you can stream elsewhere. Maybe it used to be exclusive ages ago, but I think so. I'll have to look up our partnership contract again. I really don't think it's that, though. I have to look up now. I'm doing business things now. I have to. No. This match is never going to end, is it? The ball's too big to go in the thing, and everyone's too bouncy, and the ball's too bouncy that it just can't go in the fucking goal. Maybe it's like monetized stream. Finally. What do you mean Boomer scored? What? Fuck off. Oh, fuck off. Fine. Yeah, the rumor was that Google was going to buy them. Fine. That's fine. Cool. I unlocked most of the bodies on PS4 just because I play most of it on PS4 with and the first looks and stuff, but I play very little of it on PC, which comes knowing that the things don't carry over. You don't care that much about quality. Well, I know it's content. Quality of content over quality video, but ideally I'd like both. Matt, play with fans. No, I'm going to finish up now because I paid views on. I was only going to stream till 12:30 anyway. I just wanted to do this as a test. See, half the reason we want this internet was for good quality streams, and if I can't make the streams any better than they were, then what's the point? You know? I'll have another mess with this tomorrow. I'm sorry for the amount of test streams, I just need to figure this out properly. Because I want it to be better quality. I just want it. There's no point in having this good fucking internet if I can't make the quality fucking really good. Because if it's no better than my shit version, I mean, obviously I can stream consistently in this. My Virgin Media internet just fucked up a load and it made the quality terrible after a little while, and then I couldn't stream at this. I can stream forever at this quality just fine. It's not going to break down on me, which is obviously better. It's more reliable, but I'd like it to look better. So yeah, thanks for coming. If you stuck around this long, all 30 of you, fucking about 90 people left since the start. And I restarted like 8 times, but, you know. It's better, just not as good as you. Yeah, that's it. It is a bit better, but I want it to be sharp. Like, it looks, like on source, it looks fuzzy. I don't want it to look fuzzy. I want it to look sharp, and I want it to look crisp, and I want it to look like a nice HD video. And my bandwidth should be able to do that. Because the thing is, I know on like my channel at least, you know, when I don't have the quality options, streaming at a really high bit rate at a really high resolution is going to be fucking a pain in the ass because it obviously a lot of people with lower bandwidth are going to fucking struggle with that. But on a partner channel or when you have quality options, it's fine. Because if you have the bandwidth to do it, great, you can watch it in high quality. But if not, then there are options for you. You know, there's the high, there's the different quality options and. That's kind of what I'm banking. Oh my god, my mic fell over. That's what I'm sort of banking on. So. Twitch is a pain in the ass. Seriously, Twitch is a pain in the ass. I say, we've had some headbutting with them recently. So. The Danophobia streams are your favourite. I really like the Danophobia streams. The big, long, late-night ones. We'll probably do one of those again soon. I've been planning another one. I really want to do one in sort of Viscera cleanup detail. We just get a really big Viscera cleanup detail map, and we just spend, like, 7 hours just cleaning. I'm down for that. We'll probably do that again soon, because I've moved now, and I've got my computer set up now. So I can basically do them whenever, which is really good. I still have a bunch of stuff set up here. I basically most of my stuff's still in boxes. Problem with this flat is most of the stuff in boxes is like show off stuff. You know, it's like Lego and figurines and shit because I started collecting them in the past year. And I have nowhere really to put them now because I brought two shelves with me. But my old place had a lot of built-in shelving and stuff. I had a lot of windowsills. I don't have windowsills or anything here, so. I need a lot more shelving to put them up, so I just haven't emptied any of them. But I've got my computer set up. That's the main thing. The echo is a problem. You can probably hear a bit of an echo. I've got some sound dampening foam up, but I need to get more of it. I need to put it up in more places. But once I decorate in here and I get the sound dampening foam, it should be great. Should be fine. Good. Any 1v1v games, they're all. I want to play Hover Junkers together, definitely. And we're going to have a good mess, don't worry. We're going to do Vive stuff. But the Vive stuff we might do on, we might do the Vive stuff on a video instead of a stream. We might do some stuff on a stream, but I think we might do some videos. Of the E3 streams, yeah, Dan, I don't think we'll be at any of the E3 streams. I think he's doing other things. My voice is dying. aside from the cough, I'm alright. It's just a bit gravelly. It doesn't hurt or anything. He probably won't be in all of them. I don't think he's going to be in any of them, unfortunately. Because unlike last time, they were sort of spread over a couple of days. This time they're basically ones on like Sunday night and all the rest are like early, like 3 a.m. Monday to like late on Monday. They're all on that day. And I think it's just that day he's away. I mean, he might try and do them from where he is, portable. He might try and get in one of them, but I don't think. What do you mean, please? I'm not tired. My voice is a bit gravelly, but that doesn't mean I'm tired. I'm staying up with the fucking baby. I'm fine. but yeah. Yes. Cool. That's the plan. I'll get this sorted out. There'll be a Patreon Q&A. They're actually the most popular VOD videos on the channel. The Fluster Glucks aren't very popular at all because people got put off by Minecraft's one especially. That's the most disliked video on the channel. The Minecraft fluster clock. So, yay. I'm not even blaming myself for that because I had a plan. And most people didn't like it because people were going against my plan. So I'm fine with that. but in. But yeah, the Patreon Q&As do very well. The podcasts do pretty well as well. But the Patreon Q&A will probably be doing it on Friday, I think. If everything goes to plan, because I'm away this weekend from Saturday to Monday. And that's the last weekend of the month. So we'll probably try doing it on Friday. If nothing changes, it'll probably be on Friday. So, yeah. That's the plan. No, the most disliked was, I think, Goat Simulator. But the Fluster Clock has taken over. I mean, I get a guess. I'm kind of proud of that in some way. I mean, yeah, it's got 1,500 dislikes. I mean, the ratio is still quite high. I mean, the majority of people still liked it. This is the thing, even, I mean, this being the most disliked video is very good, because even, it's got a lot of dislikes, it's got 1,500 dislikes, but the ratio is still very high. So, I mean, that's pretty good, isn't it? The first look make you dislike Dan. I think it's because people mess around more in them. They're a lot less. I think maybe people like the Q&As and the podcasts more, because you know the way I'm talking now in a more, in a deeper, more relaxed, serious voice. I haven't been swearing, because I swear for comical effect. This is me talking somewhat, you know, seriously. Oh, when I say serious, you know, yeah, I'm talking, you know what I mean? 8K dislikes and goats in. What? Ah, oh, Dan must have been lying to me then. He said it was the most disliked video on the channel. That's, oh yeah, no, it's definitely the Goat Simulator one. No, it's definitely the Goat Simulator one. Good lord. 1/3 dislikes. Oh, the COD trailer, yeah, it's the second most disliked video on YouTube. But the, yeah, no, the well, we, because we talk like this in the podcasts and the Q&As, we talk seriously. It's the deeper voices, it's a bit more relaxed, it's a bit more serious, it's a bit more chatty. People like chatty. People really like, especially on the Nerdcubed channel, I think people are a bit more, you know, if you want shouty, a lot of people would go to PewDiePie and they're like, which isn't bad, some people want that and that's fine. But I think a lot of people that come to Nerdcubed want a bit more talky, thinky, because a lot of the jokes Dan does are a bit more clever jokes. So people maybe want the talky a bit more. And the Fuster Clucks aren't that. They are jokey and loud and silly. Which is fine. I think a lot of people like, I think it's good to have the variety. But I think that puts a lot of people off. And as I say, a lot of people got put off by them because the quality was bad, because I was uploading the VOD. And the VODs were bad quality because obviously my internet was shit and the audio quality was shit because I was recording directly from TeamSpeak, which there was packet loss issues because my internet. And last week I recorded locally and we got all the audio recorded locally, and the quality of the actual VOD was very good. But I think a lot of people have been put off it completely by now already, which is a shame. I think a lot of people who didn't like it originally would probably think it was all right now. But, you know, they've already went off it. They probably won't give it a chance again, which is a shame. But the stream should be a lot better quality as well, because obviously I've got the good internet now. They won't break down like they used to. Some people complain that the sound mixing in the last first o'clock because when Dan went up to his mic like this, it peaked a lot more in his local recording than it did over TeamSpeak. So when he did it over TeamSpeak, it was loud, but it wasn't, you know, blow your eardrums out. But in the one I edited, it was, because it was a bit, it wasn't as normalized. And I didn't notice that, because I don't sit through all 2 hours and check, you know, I don't have the time to sit through the 2 hours and listen to it all. Because I need to get it out within a day. So, you know, so yeah, I'll try and normalize it next time I look at Soundwave, see if anything peaks, and edit it a bit more. Yeah, that's the plan. Yeah, it's loud, isn't it? But it doesn't. A lot of people complain that it literally like blew out the headphones and shit because it. I did listen to the VOD and it's extremely loud when he does that. It's like 3-4 times the volume of the fucking thing. So yeah. Although, I blame Dan more for speaking close to the microphone. I mean, if he didn't do that, I wouldn't have to bother editing them. Anyway, whatever. Yeah, I'm going to go now. Thanks for coming, again. Get guests on the podcast. We want to do that. Originally, it was meant to be the podcast. It was meant to be... It was originally going to be called In Between Two Nerds, and it was going to be John and Dan with a special guest every week. And the first podcast... special guest was me, and obviously I turned up an hour late because I fell asleep, and my phone was on silent and I hadn't set an alarm. I think I went to bed at like 9 a.m. and I that morning, and usually I expect to wake up within, you know, 8 hours, but I was dead for some reason, so I just woke up at like 7 p.m. in a stupor over just my phone, had like a billion, like, where are you, what's talking. But ever since then, when we took the break, Dan liked me being there, and he couldn't be bothered getting a guest every 2 weeks. So, it's just that. I mean, I wouldn't mind making it a bit more like the Co-optional podcast and getting a guest every 2 weeks with us three and making it a four-person thing. But I think he likes it being a bit more like the Podquisition, where the three people, just constantly. I would like the occasional guest. I think I might try and arrange that. I have a few more contacts now, which could be interesting. Anyway, yeah, I'm going to go for real this time. I just like answering those questions and get the answers out of the way. Yeah, if you want to suggest a guest, feel free to on my Twitter or whatever. Anyway, goodbye. Thanks for coming. And fucking Jesus.